How we doing, folks? Right, today in this vlog we're in my kitchen. Hopefully that camera's not moving, because I keep thinking those legs are actually sliding. Don't know if they are, but no, yeah, we're in the kitchen today. We're gonna make some home brew up, gonna make some dark ale. Boom, check that one out. Two cameras rolling, got one up there as well. Boom, over the sink, folks. And also there's a folk behind the camera. Check this guy.
Please try not to knock the tripod legs that have been sliding. How you doing, guys?
Jamie Dench, jamiedench.com.
Yeah, go take a look, it's where all my photos are. Hmm. Anyway, this is not a plug for that. We are
making homebrew.
To try homebrew, and I've never tried homebrew before, so.
Right.
This is Ian's. Can I try a bit?
Yeah, go for it, mate. Another bit. Remember you're driving? That's stout, that is. That's
absolutely disgusting.
Yeah. It's amazing. I could drink that. I could drink a whole barrel of 40 pints. So. Yes, got a barrel. Homebrew Online is a good one to check out, folks, on eBay. They are amazing. And yeah, smooth. Got all the camera up there as well, don't forget about that. A lid. Shut that out there, mate. And an airlock to put on the top of it. It's a bit tight and it's starting to get hot in it as well.
It's small in here, folks.
Yeah, need air conditioning. And also we got this. We need this, we're gonna put, what is it? 4 pints of water into this. We're going to boil that on the old gas stove, folks. Right, so let's do that now. Right, cheers. Pint glass. This is actually a beer festival pint glass.
This is the bit that you don't see.
2015 Festival of Winter Ales, White Cliffs.
I'm not seeing the one that you're looking at. Okay. Right. This is on an iPad device, that's why.
Yeah, definitely. Right, so we're going to take this, take the lid off. I'm going to get 4 pints. Did I say 4? I think it is 4.
Four pints.
4 pints. So I don't read the instructions anymore, folks, so I just make it.
This is my first time ever. I've never done anything like this. I'm pretty good at making a cup of tea, but homebrew, no idea. Absolutely no idea.
4.
By the looks of it, it looks quite simple.
It is, yeah, it's alright, it's simple. Right, let's get this gas stove started up, folks.
This is a classic gas stove as well.
That's that. Plastics. Pop that on there. So we're going to let that boil. I'm going to put that boiled water into this and that'll do us. We don't need to do any more boiling up after that. Another swig. We're actually live on Facebook as well at the moment.
You may hear us talking.
Yeah, definitely. There's your yeast. That's what we're going to use to put on the beer once it's done. And that's the old kit. Right, what we need now is tin opener. Any tin opener. Look at the state of that. Any tin opener would do, folks.
Any tin opener.
Anyone.
As long as it's not this one.
Yeah. Right, so I'm going to put that on there. Open it up.
I've never seen inside this before.
Right. Oh, there's one thing I forgot to do as well, folks. It's pretty much a main issue, actually. Pop that there.
What was that? Oh, I've just seen why this tin is so heavy.
What's that?
Because it's a liquid inside, isn't it?
Yeah, it's malt. What's it smell like? Smells pretty darn good. So I'm going to get this kettle of water. I'm going to put the kettle on.
This that smells like Bovril.
It smells good, malt. Really thick as well. You don't want to get that on your shirt.
Ooh
dear. But we're going to boil that up, and we're going to put the boiled water into the fermentation bucket. Put the lid on, shake it about a bit to sterilise it. Just put some of that in there. Shake it about a bit. It's sterilised. Boom, sorted, folks.
Fine. Yeah, we got a 3-camera setup going on here. We've got an iPad over here, guys, for the people who are currently watching, but this is in the future. No, you're in the part in the past, something like that.
Yeah,
and then we've got a GoPro out there
that's aiming down on the sink area.
Yeah, and then iPads here,
and everyone's live here,
people that are watching.
Who's
you've got all sorts, got a few comments going on.
Well, shaking. Quick, quick. Up, turn the catch. Oh, I've got it.
Sorry, did you?
Yeah, quickly, mate.
All right. Straight in.
Yeah.
Straight in. I'm a part of this. Oh my god.
Hope it don't melt it, folks.
Oh, it's just gone on my foot.
So this is sterilising, folks. This is sterilising to the next level. This can explode.
This can. Steam bomb.
Check that. Look.
There's some guns and nudges. Wow. What is that in there?
Hot water, mate.
No, but what's that noise?
The steam, isn't it? It's hot in there. It's like a steam train.
I thought it was making a noise.
So, instead of using sterilising tablets like they use in babies' bottles and stuff, I can't be bothered with that anymore. It wastes too much water because you end up tipping that away anyway.
Time this and is, money.
How many cups does it sell in that, Jay?
That was 8 cups.
8 cups of water in that, folks.
That'd be fine.
Now sterilised. Well, better put the spoon in there.
Marcus Max says hi.
How you doing, Marcus?
Marcus, your name is also being mentioned on the other video.
So which one?
Marcus Max.
Melton, mate. Blimey, so that's some
heat.
That's sterilised now. Jesus. So we tip that water away. We won't use that.
And that's where the GoPro comes in. This is, we're getting to a good bit.
So, let's get in there. So now we put this in there.
Whoa. Let's show you guys. Look at that. It's like syrup.
You don't want to get this on your shirt or nothing like that. Alright, watch out, mate.
Go on.
Whoa. Sugar's gone in, folks. Must admit.
Must admit. Steady. Oh, we got a bit on the kitchen floor there, mate. That's it.
Oh, it's sticky. Right. Now we can put the spoon there. Don't get it on the handle, try not to. And we did that water get to the boil, then we're going to chuck that in the barrel as well. Let's just show the folks, let me lift it up a bit. Oh Dan, it's alright, don't worry. You can see there, folks, sugar and the malt is in there. So, amazing stuff. And Jamie's just holding it nice and patiently over the bucket.
This is inside.
It looks quite messy actually, but it's just Jamie's work.
If any of you see my photography, you'll know.
Right, so what we're going to do now, we've got the worst out of this can. That's boiling.
Oh, it's getting hot in here.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, that's malt, Marcus.
Where the hell is everything in here?
It's his own house, he don't even know.
I'll choose that. Hope it don't crack. We'll pour the bits of hot water into this can. And then we're going to get the rest of the malt out because we don't want to waste any. It's all goodness, folks, at the end of the day, isn't it? Just put that in there, give it a stir. Watch out, mate, covering the camera. Right, so that's done. Chuck, don't do it with bare hands. Made that mistake once. Remember, because it's a tin, you put boiling water into it. You know what I mean? The top.
Steamy.
Pretty steamy. Right, we're going to put you back, guys. Yeah. Well, that's spoiled. Take that. Boiling water, chuck that in. Into there. Boom.
We're getting a little condensation here.
Is it on the lens, is it?
Slightly. Jeez. Maybe open the door a bit. Open the door. Only slightly.
Tea towel.
Why don't you open the curtains? Let some of that air in, mate.
Messy, innit? Don't get it on the floor, mate. Like that. Yeah.
Stinks.
So Jamie's stirring this in.
So, I've got an interesting question. Once this is done, how long does this get left for?
We get all to that, mate.
Okay.
All in good
time. Am I jumping ahead?
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
So we've got the sugar in there, we've got the can of malt in there, 4 pints of boiling water. In there. So we're just basically going to top this up with cold water now until it gets to the 23 litre mark.
This is it's a bit lumpy in the middle still.
That's alright, yeah, you take this now. So give it a good stir, we want to get all that oxygen into the liquid because the yeast is going to be eating the sugar. The main thing with alcohol making is the yeast
eats the sugar that you put in it, and then it creates alcohol. Easy, really. You can make alcoholic water if you wanted. You know what I mean?
I feel like I'm getting a little drunk off the fumes.
No, you won't be, mate. There's no alcohol in it.
Oh.
This is just malt and sugar. Once the sugar's been eaten by the yeast, and then the alcohol will be in it.
Yeah. Let's take a look at them.
Homebrew Online is the one to go for.
Oh, Homebrew Online, okay, not
yeah.
DIY beer.
Yeah, they send them, you get them usually in like a couple of days.
Oh, that's good.
So,
can't beat a good delivery.
No, you can't, mate. So we're going to fill this up with cold water now.
I think that is moving slightly.
Your tripod, I think it is, yeah.
I can feel it, yeah, it is, because it's just starting to touch my foot.
Bloody tripod, mate.
It's a tripod, look, this is what we've got to deal with.
LED indeed.
It's not just about doing this, also I forgot to mention, for decent fermentation, whatever you got, it's got to be between 18 and 26, I think it is, degrees C. Otherwise it's,
yeah,
if it's too cold it'll go to sleep, if it's too hot it will kill the yeast.
So give that a good stir, keep it stirring. Lovely, look at that head on that.
Just like a giant pint.
Yeah.
Whoa. This is all fluid.
I think I've got a bit too much of a head on this one, mate.
Oh.
Might need a spoon to get some of that off. I still need to put...
It'd be alright, wouldn't it? You just got to put the lid in.
In?
What? Oh, you mean you stirred it too much, haven't you?
Yeah. Well, no, it's a good thing. It's not bad. So, just need to find a spoon. There it is. Because anyway, you put I sprinkle the yeast on top of it. I don't stir it in. I just sprinkle the yeast onto it and then leave it over. Instead of if you stir it in, you know, it might get introduced into it faster, but I find, from what I've heard and stuff like that, experiences, sprinkle it over the top, leave it, it hydrates the yeast, and then it works better, I find. What's the temperature? What was 28? 26, that's alright. It's around, folks, it's around. Where was the spoon? There it is.
Okay.
Right, give it a final stir, folks. So, Jamie's here. He's taking charge. This is live as well on Facebook.
I've been in charge of doing that stuff, so.
So we're gonna cut this. This is yeast. Smell that. Smells good, folks. Smells good.
Smells a bit dirty.
No, it's gonna dirty. Watch me.
Gonna drop it. Make your finger.
This stuff multiplies really badly, mate.
Does it?
Yeah, it's bacteria, basically. You're introducing it into the beer. Sort of style, isn't it? You know what I mean? So it's going to start eating the...
Yeah, I can see already, mate.
Hello?
Is it ready yet,
Hugh? Hey, are you watching it, Dave?
I was in it.
So what we're going to do now is get the airlock. This is the airlock. Just get that there. So Jamie's got the iPad that you can see in the shot.
Sorry.
So we're going to put a little tiny bit of water in that.
B-Joy's watching.
Hi, B-Joy. How we doing, folks? So, that's on that. And then we've got the plastic lid there, it's got a bit of malt on it, but that's fine. I'm going to put that on now. Squeeze that on so it's airtight. And now all that yeast on there is just going to sit there, so we're going to pop that on there. Seal it down. All the sugar's in there, all the yeast, so it will start at some point. There. So that's that.
Boom.
That might go boom later, you never know. But it's about, you're going to wait for probably about a week. Basically until the bubbling stops. Once the bubbling stops and the bulge in the actual lid goes down, the fermentation has stopped, the fermenting. And it's going to be ready to transfer into bottles or a barrel. I put them in a barrel, pressure barrel, 40 pints. And I don't know what camera to look at.
So, how long does it take now till we can drink this?
Hmm.
I'd like to know that as well.
About 3 weeks.
Minimum. 3 weeks?
Minimum.
3 weeks minimum.
I'd say 1 week for fermentation, 4 days or whatever it takes. If it's hotter, it'll take it faster. I've had it fermented 2 days.
Really? Is that during the summer?
A hot day, yeah.
Okay, so anyone else got any other questions while we're here on this one? I just want to ask as well, how do you know that it's ready to drink? Can you just tell by the taste?
Well, once 2 weeks is up, folks, I'm drinking it.
So it'd be good to know, the guys on live as well, and you guys, do you drink homebrew at home? Because it seems to be quite popular. I've seen a few shops where they sell the kits like Ian's made today and showed me how to do it. Do you guys drink it? Do you buy it? If you do, what's your favourite? That's a good
Put
question.
Put it down in the comments section, yeah, folks. Yeah, definitely.
So, where did you learn to make beer? And that's from Lewis Fernson.
I'll tell you what. Get on YouTube, folks, and check out a channel called Craig Tube.
Yeah.
Canadian bloke who does home brewing, and he was basically the bloke who got me into it.
Oh, nice.
Bless him, yeah. He's still knocking videos out every week, I think. Craig Tube.
So,
in the description, folks.
How long you say you've been making it for now?
2012 I started making
it. Since 2012, yeah. So that's 5 years, guys. You knew that Madness. Anyway.
Yeah.
5 years, that's crazy, mate.
Crazy stuff.
That is crazy. Stan Pollard put Guinness is the best. Would you agree with that?
Not Guinness, no.
Guinness is like
real raw stout or porter.
I think
Guinness
yes.
is overdone, Guinness is watered down.
Stan's
in my opinion.
Canada, yeah. I agree with you there. I think some of the best stuff are the little people, like little companies that make them.
Yeah, yeah.
You get one off or something.
The head, the smooth head, I don't really care about. It's, you know, I'd like to drink a, like this didn't really have head on it, really.
Yeah.
After a while, it was just sort of just black. But, yeah, just 100% raw stout and porter. Amazing.
100%
raw. Amazing days, you know. Yeah, amazing.
When can we expect to see IKS Exploration out of hell on earth? I'd like to see.
Yeah, they live up north, folks, so whenever they want to come down, or we will go up to them and sort something out very soon, hopefully. So, come on, Johnny Norton, let's sort something out.
Yeah, if you're watching Johnny Norton. How many pints is a perfect session? Oh, we've got some good questions here, guys. We've got some really good questions.
I don't know because I don't remember, you know, to a certain point.
I've been out of him drunk, and I'm going to say you can put away quite a bit. He's more than me. More than me. I think maybe we'll do this again. That was good fun, wasn't it?
We'll sort of hang out again.
For sure, man. For sure.
It's a bit different than exploring, isn't it? But again, it's exploration in beer making.
Yeah, that's it.
So,
that's it. Exploration. See you later.
Cheers, folks.
See ya. Bye.
So there you go, folks, that's how you make beer. Hope you enjoyed that. It's a different vlog, but as I see it, it's an exploration, IKS exploration, into beer making. Cameras there as well, so we've got multiple cameras in there.
We've ended the live now.
Last session's
over.
Thanks very much, Jamie, for taking control of that.
Fine.
Yeah, because I can only do one thing at a time. So I'll take the questions or make the beer.
I actually really like the live feature on Facebook and YouTube.
Yeah. It didn't work on the iPhone for some reason.
No, that was strange. That was strange, but guys, I think maybe we should get the guys to comment if they like that, doing
Live streaming.
Live stream and maybe do a live stream video.
Well, we need to do the question and answer video at some point as well.
Yeah, we'll get Adam to do that and
do recording and live of that.
I think that would be very good.
There'd be a behind the scenes when it's what's been cut. Whatever.
Let's do that. You guys want to see that? Comment below. That'd be really cool.
Boom, down there.
Cool to
so,
do.
So, I think that's pretty much it. Vlog 35, 34. Whatever it is, it'd be on the top, wouldn't it?
I'd just like to say this, Ian. I really appreciate you asking me to come up.
That's all right, yeah.
I feel like I'm really
Thanks
part
for
of the IKS family. I know I don't go out on all the vlogs and stuff like that. And
we've all got lives to live, folks.
And so. I'm not the biggest history buff like Ian and Chris, but I really feel like I'm part of this and I really enjoy it, so fit there, brother.
Brofist.
But yeah, no, that's cool. He's been a long time friend as well.
Check out Hell on Earth, folks.
Yeah, check them out. Check the guy with the beard. He's hilarious.
Oh, Johnny.
Yeah, Johnny, he's hilarious.
Johnny Norton.
I think he's
They're
really
all funny.
Funny,
they're all funny.
I'd like to have a beer
Lloydie
with him.
And Norton and Al.
I'd really like to have a beer with them.
Yeah, they need to come down and we go up there
and
we'll do like a weekend up there or something like that and just get really drunk.
Take them some of this.
Yeah. I'll be drunk, I'll be drinking that on the way up.
Make them a special one, a Hell on Earth special.
Yeah. Really strong. I don't do strong beer, I make Belgian beer a while ago.
Belgian. Yeah, nice.
Mental. So, jamiedench.com, is it?
yeah, it's my photography. I shoot on film, if some of you don't know. And you're doing vlogs, because Ian's about to say
I think you should open up your vlogs again, mate.
Yeah, the vlogs are very good. Just give you a little bit of background. Just bought a new house. Things are incredibly busy, but once that's mellowed out, we decorated and all that, I'm going to try my best
to get back on it. Yeah, so keep on it, mate.
Because obviously I work as well, so it takes a bit of time to do the editing. So
yeah,
but yes, you can look forward to that, I'm sure.
Yeah, thank you very much, Jamie.
Thank you.
Thank you, folks, for your support, and see you soon.
Yeah, enjoy. Go and make some homebrew.
Yeah,
do it.
Get down your local store, pick up some kits. Homebrew Online will be down in the description as well. They're a good company. Their website and
the eBay account. Pew!
Boom.
Messed myself up there with the cabling. Come down this way, didn't I?
That up at some point.
What the hell's going on here? Wow. That's still got the gates in place.